All right, so that is where the ECUs are. So there is the good old Motronic 5.2.
Yes, sir.
And there's one right here as well.
Nope, not on these cars.
What? I'll be damned. It's only got one?
Yep.
So are you recording all of the nefarious activities?
Seriously, this one only has one ECU?
Yeah.
They tried it.
Wait a minute. Like, my mind is blown here because like every Ferrari I thought had two ECUs.
Well, the 2.7 355 does. They're up in the rear quarter panels. You know, see where that bracket is that you unbolted the trim panels from?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where the two ECUs.
No way.
But yet, this car has a single ECU.
Because even like the new stuff has two ECUs.
Correct.
My mind just went.
They were like, we don't like this single ECU nonsense.
What the hell? So this one won't do the run on half a bank and all that stuff?
Pretty much.
Oh, so, well, that's like good and bad, right?
Yeah.
Wow, I am, I don't even know what to say here. I'm at a loss. you've ruined my, just when you think you know Ferraris, that gets thrown at me.
Welcome to my life.
Yeah. And people are like, yeah, these Ferraris, yeah, they're... Why am I paying you so much, Josh? No idea. Well, it's got the same giant-ass plug thing.
Yeah, they just changed the pin counts.
Oh, okay.
Like, the very early cars only had 25 pin. This one's got an 88 pin. So there's breakout boxes for these. You probably remember from a Testarossa we did a while back. I don't have an 88 pin for this particular ECU at this particular moment in my life. They're not super easy to come across. If anybody finds one, let me know.
Yeah.
So we're going to do this the old-fashioned way, which is just
clip it to the wires.
Yep, we're just going to back pin the actual connector itself.
Fun. So Josh has his little digital voltmeter. He's got him connected to certain pins, and then he's got his Bible, which tells him what things to do.
Correct. There are a couple different tests, right? We're going to ohm out a bunch of things. We're going to check voltage on a bunch of things, all static kind of tests, right? Then there are a series of checks you can do with the engine running using both the voltmeter and an oscilloscope. We're obviously not going to worry about running checks because we have ignition problems in this car keeping it from running properly. So we're not going to get reliable engine running stuff.
Yep.
So for right now, we're just going to worry about all the static tests.
Okay.
Right?
So this at least will tell us what parts we need to buy.
Yeah.
Generally.
Yep. So this is the... Fable diagnosis sheet number 22 for the Motronic 5.2 and the 355. I've got the full first volume, which is 24 different sheets. And it starts pretty elementary, right? So we're going to check four different ground wires on the wiring harness and make sure we've got good ground resistance. Then we're going to check for battery voltage on a pin. And then we start pinning out the fuel injectors, coolant temp sensor, intake, air temp, et cetera, et cetera. So basically all the electronic components aside from cam sensors, crank sensors, lambda sensors, we're not really checking
Because they have to be running.
Right. Those are all oscilloscope where they put out a waveform, and we're not checking those because the motor's not going to run now because we just ripped the dead ignition apart. This will get us close enough, though. We can pick at those last things if we decide to do, like, plugs and wires on it before we rip the motor out and stuff, and then get it running. Then we can go through and check those stuff as a final check, or after the service is done, we can do those as final checks. For ECU ground, 200 ohm scale on the DVM, we want less than 2/10 of an ohm of resistance, and we're going to check pins 6, 28, 34, and 55. The Bible here tells us what those pins are. You don't really need that, you just need the specs, because all of the pins, not all, but you have some markers here at the end of each row on the ECU. Oh,
okay.
So I basically emulate their pattern on a notepad.
Oh.
So when I don't have to sit here and look at the two of these, that is a visual representation, as I'm looking at it. Pin one is bottom right, and pin 88, our final pin, is top left. As I'm looking at the back of the connector, easy peasy. Ground lugs are here on the body where the ECU mounts. That'll be adequate. It's metal. So we'll go to pin 6. Real simple. We just count over. 5/10, close enough. We're not going to worry about that. OK, Okay, pin number 28 is here at the end. Yeah, 4/10, close enough.
A little bit better.
Pin 34, so now we go up a row. And so far, all of the ground wires are just black wires as well.
5/10.
5/10, close enough. That was 34, and now we go to 55, which we know is at the end of that row. And so here's your wild card, right? So pin 55, the first three were just plain black wires. Pin 55 is a green with black stripe on this car.
Ooh. Oh, there it goes.
Yeah. That one might have a little more, little bit more dirty connection. You can see as I move it around the pin, we get different resistance values. So, I mean, the car's 24 years old, so it's not real surprising. We already know we've got a good 12 volts to the ECU because we've started the car and run it, right? We're not diagnosing a dead ECU problem. So frankly, I'm not real worried about that. So I'm not gonna bother having them kick the key on. That sort of check is more like, yeah, if you got a car that won't start, you know, it's misbehaving for some reason, then it's, you know, pretty handy to go through and do the voltage check. Fuel injectors, for all 8 injectors, we use ground pin 54 for all of them.
Gotcha.
So the entire injector harness uses a common ground, and then we got a separate pin number for the positive feed for each individual injector.
Yep.
We know for sure we can take the ground pin, stick it in number 54. We know where 54 is because we wrote that out and we just did that. 54 is the green wire next to the green with black. So we'll do that one. And now we go to pin 3. And these should be, these are high impedance injectors, 16 ohms plus or minus 4. Yeah, 20 ohms, so we're kind of right there. Pin 4, 18, okay. And then we've got pin 5. 18, pin 7, there we go, 18. Now 31, 32, 33, 35. Injectors are mostly within range. We had like 2 there that checked kind of funny. But when I do majors on older cars, especially if you're doing a refresh on a motor like this, I'd send the injectors out to a specialist anyway to have them service them, make sure the coil's in good shape, make sure they're clean, make sure the valves are in good shape, make sure the flow patterns are, you know, nice and clean and all that stuff. So this is, you know, mostly for the video exercise. I don't really care what the injectors are doing because I'd send them out anyway. You know,
I didn't know there's a, is there a guy in town that does that?
Not in town.
Okay, you just gotta
mail
him.
There is a place in town. I haven't really used them. There's a couple of specialists in the country that I like to use. All right, so this is gonna be the coolant temp sensor. You'll see here we actually have a range, right? Because the resistance of the coolant temp sensor changes based on coolant temp.
Right.
So we've got a couple of different value specs based on what our actual coolant temperature is.
Right, yep.
We can extrapolate.
I remember that.
Yep. Let's see, we did that on a Timmy's car,
or
right?
The Testarossa.
On the TR?
Yeah.
So pin 74 and 71. So on the 20K ohm, 2.5. So that's probably about right. It says for 40 degrees Celsius, it should be 1.2K ohms plus or minus 150. We're at 1.32. We could do a quick math on the phones and just kind of verify areas that we're not way above or below the range. Okay. So now we're going to keep 71 here. We're going to do air temperature sensor check. Pin 16, 4 on the 20K. Let's see, and this is for air temperatures of about 20C would be 2.5. So we're probably about right there because we're quite a bit above 20C right now.
Yeah. Probably up to like 35 centigrade, maybe higher, 37. Yeah.
All right. So we'll call that good. Checking volt, you know, 12 volts for like the AC activation. And then we get into all of the engine running stuff, which we can't do here.
Right,
so
right.
Pretty much everything seemed to check, you know, within spec. You know, the lambda sensors are the only kind of wild card. Yeah, here we go. We can do the other one that's really good to do is these cars are sensitive on a throttle position sensor.
Oh.
So engine off and key on and ECU connected. I like to do those because the throttle position sensors do go bad on 355s. they get sticky points in them because they're a potentiometer type, not a non-contact type. So we'll check that now. That's a millivolt. So we'll be on the 20 volt circuit, pins 21 and 55. All right, Mr. Adam, key on, immobilizer off, key on. You can flip this. At rest, it should be between 400 and 600 millivolts. We're at 53 or 530, so that's fine. And then at wide open throttle, it should be 3 to 4 volts. So go ahead and whack it all the way. There you go, 4 volts.
Nice.
So now, nice and like as slowly as you and smoothly as you can, we're gonna watch the rising rate. See how the numbers pretty consistently rise. Yeah. They don't really like jump up or jump down.
Yeah.
Even though the voltage we're seeing isn't perfectly consistent, and it won't be because, you know, the rate at which he's opening the throttle, you know, it's a very sensitive reading. This is not an oscilloscope, it's just a voltmeter, you know, but what we want to make sure is we don't see the voltage jumping up and down or just stopping for a period of time. So you can go ahead and gently roll off it. There you go, nice and smooth. All right, so yeah, the only wild cards are the mass airflow sensor and the lambda sensors, which with these specs, we're not able to check without the engine running properly. So that's it, we're done for now.
Today Yay! It's all about how mass airflow sensors can be a pain.
Yes, they are important. They're important, they cause a lot of runability problems. In general, electrically, it seems like the engine management's in pretty decent condition. There are no obvious issues. The ground's all pinned out pretty okay for everything. So, yeah, we shouldn't have any major electrical problems we're dealing with during the major service.
Hooray! One thing went right.
Yep. That's it. Everything else sucked.
Only one. Just one.
So will you do this all again when we put it back together?
Not unless we have a problem. If it runs right when it's all back together, you know, we do the live parameters check. Like, see here, this is with the SD1 and the engine idling, here are the value ranges we want to be seeing. So like injection time, 3 to 3.7 milliseconds, but we're seeing 4.2, 4.5 because it was trying to overcompensate because of the misfiring. So there's some, you know, pretty simple indicators here that give us an idea whether or not we're in operating range or not. So once the service is done, we'll do a live values check with the computer again. And if the motor sounds good and all the live values look good, we'll just put miles on it until all the readiness monitors set for emissions testing. And if those all set, then that's as, you know, close as we're gonna get to, you know, making sure everything's happy and healthy, because at the end of the day, it's still an old used car and anything can happen.
All right, YouTube, well, there you go. We kind of did the initial diagnostics on this car. You can see that is clearly an important step of any major. And frankly, some of that stuff is what you want to do before you buy one of these cars. And again, the major kit that we got is from Recambi America. So go check out recambiamerica.com. Use code NGS10. And it'll hook you guys up. And also a huge, huge thanks to Josh again from Exotic Power and Performance, exotic-power.com. He has helped us out on many, many projects and sounds like he's gonna be helping us out quite a bit on this one as well. So also real quick, don't forget, put in the comments below how many quacks you think this whole series is gonna have. I mean, I'm thinking it's way over 100. It's gotta be over 100, but that's just me.
We're anyway. Pretty close to 100
now. No, I mean, I think we're at like 20 something. I don't know. Just guessing. I think we're at like 20, maybe. But there's a couple more. So thanks for making my editing job more difficult. All right, guys. We're going to be working on this 355, so we're going to start pulling out the engine very soon. So you guys are going to want to stay tuned for that. So please like, share, and subscribe. That does help us out. And again, visit normalguysupercar.com. Buy some products and service from us. That actually pays for us to do these sorts of things. So that is our job. We thank you tremendously for all of you that support us. Thank you so much. We're gonna be doing a lot of car stuff. You're gonna wanna stay tuned.
It's gonna be sweet.
It will be sweet.
It's gonna be expensive.
Yeah, it's gonna be expensive.